I don't show again. It's me, Okoro Blessing, your number one relationship expert. Okay, and today I'm bringing you a very, very important topic: how to know that you are in an unserious relationship. Many of you have often come to my DM, Okoro Blessing, how do I know that this man is taking me serious? Blessing, how do I know that this man is taking me serious? Blessing, tell me. Blessing, can you tell me something today? I have made up my mind to tell you how to know that you are in an unserious relationship. Listen and you shall be blessed. One aspect to know that you're in a serious relationship: they never call you. Yes, that man, that woman that is always giving excuse, I'm busy, I'm this, I'm that, I didn't call you because my mother have died, I didn't call you because my sister have died, I didn't call you because my brother have died. When you start to get all those kind of people, you are in a serious relationship. Priority, it is very, very important. When you get into a relationship with somebody and they do not prioritize you, they're always giving you excuses. Sorry, I fell asleep. Sorry, I was bathing. Sorry, I was in a meeting. Sorry, my neck break. Every time they're giving you one silly excuse or the other. My darling, you're in a serious relationship. Number two, they can hardly have a long conversation with you. When they call you, hello? Okay. All right. Yes. All right. They can't keep a long conversation with you. You're in a serious relationship. When there's nothing to talk about. Ha! Run! On serious relationship. Number three, contribution. When you get involved with somebody and they cannot add anything into your life, they cannot contribute anything into your life, they cannot give you anything. My darling, you're in a serious relationship. You know why? Because love comes with giving. Anybody that tells you that love does not come with giving, that person that I said, the person is a blatant liar. The person lie, person. If I give the person the audio card. Contribution. If they come into your life and they cannot add anything to your life, they cannot add anything. They're only subtracting, collecting, collecting, collecting. If the collecting is more than the contribution, my darling, we're in a serious relationship. Run away. Run away. Why are you running? Number four, effort. If you're in a relationship and they are not putting in effort, you tell the person, baby, please, can you help me bring this eyeglass? Don't tell me to ask boy. Baby, please, can you help me bring my phone? Anything to them is stress. When people are in an unserious relationship, they don't want to put any effort. They don't want to stress themselves. They just want to be the way they are. On serious relationship, run away. Effort, very, very important. Many of you are in relationship that you do not pay attention. Pay attention to this thing. Pay attention. Number five, satisfaction. When you are in a serious relationship, they don't care about you. They are very selfish people. If they keep this phone here, okay, this is where I like the phone. Leave the phone there. Leave the phone. This is how I like it. They keep this eyeglass here. Leave the eyeglass there. Don't change it. Very selfish point of people. They don't want to satisfy you. It's always about them. Can I ask you, why are you in a relationship? You are in a relationship so that the person can better you. You are in a relationship so that you can move to the next level. Relationship is like teamwork, because two good heads is better than one. Then if you're in a relationship and the person cannot satisfy you, the person cannot sacrifice for you, what are you still doing there? My darling, you're in a serious relationship. Now, one also. Number six, which is the last one. They talk more than they act. You see, when you're in a serious relationship, the audio will be more than the video. I can pass on audio. Every time, talk. No action. When you are in a serious relationship, all you'll be seeing is video. If they play, if they show. They go, they talk and do. These are the kind of people you should be in a serious relationship with. But the people that are taking you very, very unserious, that just talk. Baby, Shady, I say I love you. Baby, you know I love you. Baby, do you know I love you? Baby, I foresee I love you. Baby, but I talk, say I love you. Baby, do you know? Audio. My darling, run for your day life. You are in a serious relationship. There's one very thing that used to annoy me in relationship. A marriage, I used to hear. Endure. Can you please endure? Let me tell you something. Many of you keep enduring the wrong things in relationship and marriage. Stop enduring people's character. Stop enduring people's attitude. That is the most stupid thing to endure in a relationship and a marriage. Character and attitude. You know why? Because this character and attitude can be changed. Of course, yes. Character and attitude can be changed. Nobody was born with it. It was something they emulated or something that they are reacting to. So if you are that woman or that man that is enduring somebody's character or enduring somebody's attitude, my darling, you are a fool. Character is not supposed to be endured. Attitude is not supposed to be endured. It can be changed. That is not who they are. Have you ever wondered why your husband or your boyfriend will be beating you? Every time you come back home, they will beat you, but they cannot beat their side chick. They cannot beat their girlfriend. It's only you that they are beating. You know why? It's because that is what you have accepted. Leave him. That is who I am. Love me for who I am. This is me. I shout naturally. I'm a normal temper issue. I used to be angry. When I get angry, my husband is an angry person. It's his attitude. I am praying for him. My wife is a nag. She was it's a lie. Does she nag to her boss in the office? It's a very big fat lie. It's either you are doing something that is making her nag, or she's just nagging because she's misunderstanding something. My point is, that thing that she's doing can be changed. Why endure it? Can you be enduring what can be changed? The only things you can endure are things you don't have power over, are things that cannot be changed. Things like medical issues. Let's assume that your husband is having diabetes, and they say, okay, because of the diabetes, he have low sperm counts. Endure. Let's assume your wife cannot give birth because of one circumstances or the other. Endure. Endure things that you do not have power over. Things that you cannot change. Those are the things that are supposed to be endured. But you see the things that you can change. Character and attitude. And you endure it. My darling, you're wasting your time. Makandi Rabasoko, ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Change my husband. That woman that is chasing my husband. Every side chick. Every spirit. You are wasting your energy and your time. My darling, pray for your business. My darling, pray for your children. Pray for yourself. It is an attitude. He will be the one to change it. He will decide to change it. It is not a spiritual problem. Oh, my man, man. These same men, they travel outside the country, they cannot touch a woman. Go and be the white woman. They lock inside kirikiri, that your spiritual problem will change. My husband will stop enduring rubbish. Mm-hmm. So I've been able to give you 6 different ways to know that you're in a serious relationship. Number 1, they never call you. Number 2, they can't even keep in a long conversation because there's nothing to discuss. Number 3, no contribution. They are only there to collect. Number 4, they don't put in any effort. They are just there. Number 5, they are very selfish. They can never do anything to satisfy you. Number 6, they are the master and the mistresses of audio, no video. They don't show you anything. Now talk. Now you fool this thing. With this few talk of mine, I hope I've been able to convince and not to confuse you. How to know that you are in a serious relationship.